What is going on, everybody? It is a big monumental episode for this upcoming Bleach episode, which is going to be 34, or if any of you have watched the old anime, it will be episode 400, a monumental milestone for the anime, and of course the manga too. But also, what an episode to have it on, because it is one of Kubo's favorite characters, being Mayuri Kuratsuchi, for Bleach episode 34, Baby Hold Your Hand. So, we're going to get into the spoilers, we're going to talk about everything that I have to say, and yeah, let's just get into it. Of course, hit that like, that subscribe, and let's get into it, shall we? So as I said at the start of the video, it is a big milestone episode, so congratulations to Bleach for reaching 400 episodes, and what an episode to have it on. There's a lot of expectations with this episode, which I'll get on furthermore after we talk about the screenshots and also the synopsis. To be honest with you, the screenshots, not that special, if I'm honest with you. I have more to say other than the screenshots, but we're probably going to breeze past them. But let's talk about the synopsis first and foremost. Saraki and Kuratsuchi Mayuri were heading for the fourth. We're heading from the fourth Breach Street to the True World Castle. Blocking their path was Pernida, Kenpachi tried to overpower Pernida, who had a mysterious and unknown fighting power. By using a straightforward approach, but even when Kenpachi slammed his blade into Pernida, or Penida, before anyone tries to correct me, it was not a decisive blow. But he was hit head-on by Penida's power. While calmly analysing the battle, Mayuri felt joy in the face of a series of unexpected events. Now, of course, please do not try and correct my pronunciation. We heard it once from Yuha in the last episode. You know, I'm gonna have a habit. I've been reading Bleach for a long time. The habit of saying some names in some way through poor translations in the past is what it is, right? So I've only heard the name once. I can't remember how it was fully pronounced, but I'm sure we'll hear a lot of Pernida or Peninda's name again in the next episode. So from the dog a bone here, right? So obviously I know what's going to be happening, but of course first I want to talk about the screenshots before I give my take. So first and foremost, first screenshot, Mayuri looking that face is just, it is something. It's Mayuri. You're really just not going to get many images giving you any real detail in regards to this episode for some reason, but do you know what? They did that the last episode, and look what we got. We got some really good stuff with Iryu and Renji. So do you know what? They're showing the bare minimum, and I'm all for it, to be honest with you. Still, it still gives us something to talk about. Then we have a picture of Pernida. We're going to see the reveal in this image right here. You see the cloak or the coat kind of unravel or get ripped apart. This is probably going to be very interesting for anime-only fans. I'm very excited to see what their reaction is going to be with this. I don't think it's going to be CGI. I don't. I think there's going to be some moments of CGI, but I feel like in this case, it is going to be drawn. And I think, not that I know, but I'm going to be very excited nonetheless. Next one, Kenpachi. This is going to be Kenpachi seeing Pernida before he does his revealing of what he is. And then, of course, this is probably Kenpachi rushing in to give him a hit, as we just read in the synopsis, and having whatever happened to him. Then we have Nemu, which is probably her observing Kenpachi, or probably just watching the start of Mayuri versus Pernida. I think that's probably what we're looking at here. Again, very interesting shot for them to choose. Nemu is going to be playing a very significant role within this episode, and truth be told, I love Nemu. She's a great character. She's really funny. I wish she had way more build-up and way more screen time, and I'm really interested to see how the episode is going to give her spotlight and make you care, if that makes sense. And then last but not least, Ikaku and Yumichika. That's it. No Hanatoro. And there's nothing for me to say on these images. It is literally the bare bones. It looks like it is literally the start of the episode in these images, and you're honestly just going to get more context throughout the PV. In regards to the PV itself, the original one, the trailer that we had for Core 3, is that we are now running to a point where after this episode, it's just the Kyoraku scenes that we have left. And then after that, it's content we haven't seen. There is a picture of Basby, granted. I don't know if we saw that from last episode or if it's going to be in the upcoming episodes, but I mean, now we're getting into, like, we don't know where we're going type thing. So Again, very fantastic episode. We should be getting Kyoraku versus Lele Baron next episode. I do believe the poem for next episode is going to be Kyoraku. So Baby Hold Your Hand is going to be, I'm not going to say condensed. I feel like that's the wrong wording. It depends on how it's paced. It's all going to be in this one episode. And I'm excited for it. And I think the reason why I'm excited for it and why there's so much expectation for this episode as a whole is because, one, we saw the PV, right? We saw the trailer. We saw some really dynamic eye movements. We see some great CG. We see some great effects with Mayuri. We see some great fluidity, some great artwork within the PV alone, which I think, you know, gave people an expectation for this fight in particular. I feel like Baby Hold Your Hand has been one of the most anticipated, probably next to Kyoraku in this arc, I would say. I mean, Ichigo versus Uryu was a surprise, so no one was really anticipating that, so to say. In terms of anticipations, I do think that this is the fight that people were waiting for, because not only does it look good in the PV, but also this is Kubo's his baby. You know, when Kubo was in the manga and he was doing the manga and he was sick, he put a lot of time into this Baby Hold Your Hand mini series, right? Like, there's multiple chapters. He put a lot of time for some reason into this fight, right? Mayuri is his favorite character, and it was a great fight. And it's going to be in one episode, so that's going to be interesting. And given what we have from the staff listing, now, okay, people are going to like Wakabayashi as the episode director. I'm going to say a hot take, and this is purely my preference. Wakabayashi is an amazing director, right? He knows how to do some great stuff. But I will say, his storyboards on episode 18 is probably my first conscious knowledge of Wakabayashi. And episode 18, to me, wasn't, in terms of direction, wasn't something I favored all that much, because every time I think of episode 18, for some reason, I just think of very up close camera shots that look like they were zoomed in too much, right? And when I was looking at the Blu-ray, I was hoping that these camera shots were going to be zoomed out a little bit, because I felt like the camera was too close to certain faces and actions. So I'm hoping that vision of Wakabayashi in my head kind of disappears. But to be honest, as my first conscious Wakabayashi episode, I wasn't that impressed. But I've seen his other works, and it's like, okay, hopefully this is going to be the one that does it for me. It's a big episode, and to have Wakabayashi on here gives me some hope and faith that, like, they've really chose a good... I mean, the staff listing looks great on this so far. So I think that this is going to be one of those ones, and that's surprising considering what we had last episode was fantastic. So a lot of expectation going into this episode, and I don't know if that's a good or a bad thing, because expectations, having a high expectation, can ruin a lot of people's perception, even if it is an amazing episode nonetheless. But you just can't meet some people's realistic expectations at all. So it's going to be a big one. I think lots of people are going to be surprised if you're anime only. You know, more deaths are on the way, and I'm just this is going to be one. I don't know what I want to say, but this is that episode that's like, it's going to be either good or really bad. And I don't think there's an in-between. But hopefully, I think we're going to do well. I think we're going to do well. It's Mayuri, man. It's fucking Mayuri. People love Mayuri Kuretsuchi. And then after that, we're getting another banger with Kyoraku. So, I mean, how many episodes do we have left? Is this episode 7? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8. This is episode 8. So after this, we'll have 4 more episodes. And after Kyoraku, it's like, where do we go from that? Is it going to be Asking, Grimmjow, Yoruichi, Kisuke? Who knows where we're going to go from this point? And that will be a discussion in the future. But with that being said, tell me your thoughts in the comment section down below of what you guys think. That being said, I'm going to catch you before, because I let you guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson. And as always, people, peace out.